Lando Norris is arguably the most popular young F1 racing driver. His on-track consistency just forms a part of his fan following, with his off-track presence in social media and YouTube proving to be the way he stays in constant contact with his supporters. Lando Norris is very much this generation's Formula One star. But as the previous generation stars like Vettel, Hamilton, Raikkonen, and Alonso retire, will Lando emerge as the biggest star of this decade? Before we go further, I wanted to say a quick thing. The analytics show that over 90% of you viewers of this channel are not subscribed to it yet. If you like my content, then a like and subscribe would go a long way into helping me build more interesting content for you. Thank you, and now back to the video. Born in 1999 in Bristol, England, Lando Norris has had a stellar track record in the junior classes of motor racing. He won the Karting World Championship in 2014, MSA Formula in 2015, Formula Renault and Toyota Racing Series in 2016, and Formula 3 Championship in 2017. In 2018, he raced in Formula 2 with the Carlin F2 team and finished second in the season behind none other than George Russell. He was associated with McLaren since 2017, being their junior driver and then a test and reserve driver, making an appearance in some practice sessions and even coming ahead of full-time drivers in the same teams during some of the sessions. In 2019, he joined McLaren as a full-time driver alongside Carlos Sainz. His debut season was nothing to write home about, finishing 11th in the championship with 49 points. This was quite far off from where Carlos Sainz finished, but he did out-qualify Sainz 11-10 during that season. But it is also important to note that McLaren itself was in a rebuilding phase during that season. In 2020, in the opening race in Austria, he finished P3, giving him his first podium and also his fastest lap in the race. This made him the third youngest person to ever be on a Formula One podium, behind Verstappen and Stroll. Though Norris did not make it to podium after that race in 2020, he played a crucial role, finishing 4th and 5th in a number of races and ensuring that McLaren always stayed in the game for the 3rd position in Constructors. In Abu Dhabi, Norris finished 5th and his teammate finished 6th to ensure 3rd for McLaren in Constructors, marginally ahead of Racing Point, which had to settle for 4th after Perez retired in the last race. For the 2021 season, McLaren came in with a clearly 3rd best car in the grid. Even though Norris downplayed the speed that was apparent from the preseason testing, it was clear that McLaren and Norris will be starting off the season with a solid car. Norris finished 4th in the season opener, and in the following race in Imola, he finished in the podium. This followed a series of 4th and 5th and 6th positions, ensuring that he stays in the mix for the upper midfield drivers with chance for occasional podiums. But more importantly, he has been consistently beating his teammate Ricciardo, who still has not settled in well in his new team and car. Norris's genius is clearly how he is able to consistently bring in 3rd to 5th positions and valuable points for the constructors. He has not been very consistent in the qualifying, at times having problems with the track limits, but he makes sure that he delivers by gaining places during the race. He is a very good race starter and also a very good overtaker. And these attributes are crucial for a team that is 3rd best in the grid, defending the midfield teams and battling with the likes of Red Bull up ahead. But his fan following is also attributable to his social media presence. When he is not at the circuits for the race weekends, he is mostly live streaming games, or reacting to a bunch of stuff, or posting memes on Instagram. In the past seasons, in a couple of occasions, he crashed out, he made memes of the crashes and posted on Instagram. His general funny nature makes sure that it is easy for people to like him. The fans of his racing sit through his live streams as well. To be clear, he is not the only racing driver who live streams. During the lockdown period, in early 2020, many F1 drivers had turned to live streams. One example is Charles Leclerc. Charles does streaming quite frequently these days as well. Max used to occasionally do sim racing streams as well. But none of them has the popularity out of their racing career the way Lando does. What makes Lando different is how well he does both. By 2021, he has clearly carved a space for him in Formula 1. He is currently considered one of the very good drivers on the grid. And off it, he is so very likable and probably even relatable to his audience that they can't really get enough of him in social media. But perhaps what sets Lando apart is how easygoing he is as a social media personality, and at the same time, how seriously he takes his profession as a racing driver. In 2020, when Lando came in the Beyond the Grid podcast, audience was surprised with how much in-depth this young kid was discussing about the mechanics of his car. He perhaps is one of the hardest employees of the McLaren team. And that ensures that he is able to, at the end of the day, extract maximum performance from his car. Lando might not be able to win a championship anytime soon, but if McLaren continues to improve their cars, Grand Prix victories for Lando are not that far away. But regardless of how the second half of the season turns out, Lando is already a star, and he has more than earned his fan following. And if McLaren's performance ever declines, he will never be short of options for teams to go to. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please hit that like button. Consider subscribing to the channel if you like to watch similar content. And stay tuned to I Am Formula for everything Formula One. Until next time, take care and stay safe.